Is our audio coming out soon?
We'll find out shortly.
Great match.
Keegan, remove the four ones on the lobby name. It's just WIHS, and then four ones is the password. Should be.
Say great match. See if any audio comes through. Not logged into Rocket League servers. Okay. Back.
Back. What?
Doesn't make no sense.
Go into play.
Hit play online.
What?
Oh, we can do local. Yeah. Hit local.
Do local because we should all be
host local
together.
Lobby.
Host local lobby.
We got both teams in, so we're just waiting.
Oh, all right. You're going to join the lobby that's already existing, which is
WIHS.
Is it a local lobby?
It's a private.
No, but like,
should be.
Is it local or private? Because one's online, one's local.
I think it's a private match.
Oh, yeah.
And it's WIHS1111. No, 1111. Yep. And it's the same thing for the password. Okay, you guys in?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Here we go, Rocket League Game 1, the Wisconsin High School Esports Association State Championship Semifinals between the top seed McFarland Spartans and the Elkhorn Elks. Here we go. McFarland's in the blue and Elkhorn is in the orange. First hit goes to Elkhorn Family, gets the hit to great length for Elkhorn for McFarland, gets it, almost gets it around, and it looks like Zolink is going to take it on that left-hand side, going high up into the air, and Vemini for Elkhorn is going to take that hit, take it out of the air, put it into that center link with the hit. Volt Destroyer into the center, and that is going to be knocked away. A dropping down Zolink with the hit, and off the wall, and it's going to be taken by Volt Destroyer. Yank gets it around to the left-hand side, cannot get it. Lank is a. It gets smacked by Yank. Yeah, Lank, Nick. Yank. The NG. The Squiddy. Can't get it. It's gonna go. Lank's gonna try to get it off the wall. It is centered. Almost there. Cannot get it. And Zoe. And it's gonna be taken away by Elkhorn. Moving down to the center lane. Yank gets the hit. Bounces high into the air. There's Zoe Lank. Can't get it. Lank is gonna be up. He's got the aerial. He's going to put it into that left-hand corner of Elkhorn. And it's going to be Yank that gets the hit back into the lane for McFarland. Volt Destroyer hits that up. Out, and it's passed around. Going down to the left-hand side. Goes up onto the wall. Trying to get a pass to put it in. Cannot get it. Yeah, the Squiddy's going to be able to score. But Volt Destroyer goes in and scores the first goal. Elkhorn leads 1-0. And that is going to be our first goal. Volt Destroyer gets it off a wall pass, and it's going to be a 60-kilometer-an-hour shot. As we are 1 minute and 23 seconds into the game, the Elkhorn Elks lead 1-0. Yank's going to get that first hit. Lank's going to move it up the top side. Lank going with the aerial, but he has no boost. Nothing there, Zoylink. And Yank's going to take it out of the air. Can Lank get it? Saved by Vemini! Almost, it could have been a tie game, but that is going to be an incredible save made to keep it out and preserve the lead for Elkhorn. Volt Destroyer with the hit. Can't get around. It's going to be a chance for McFarland, but it's going to be knocked out of the air by Squeeze. The only way to try to make a shot is just wide. All right, too far to the left, and that is going to be hit away by Vemini into the intersection of McFarland's zone, and that is going to be taken by Yank, actually, and Vemini's going to take control of that. It's going to be hit back into the center of the field, and Vemini's going to have to recover back. Vemini, looks like Volt Destroyer accidentally got hit. Now it's going to be teed off. Volt Destroyer blocked by a Lank going into the center. Does somebody have boost for McFarland? Nobody does. Vemini's the only one there to make the save. It's going to be hit by a Lank. Try to get a center shot. No one's going to get it, and Yank is going to take control. Oh, hitting on the wall on the right-hand side. Can't get it. Yank. The Vault Destroyer is going to take control. It hits off Yank again. The Squiddy is going to make a pass to try to hit it off the corner into the center, but that's not going to be able, and that's going to be blocked away by Vault Destroyer. Shot from McFarland. Lank. Vault Destroyer gets it, and it's going to be blocked again by Yank. Yeah. Lank gets a shot. It's saved by Vebby. Vebby gets another save for Elkhart. He's going to be passed the lane. Top left corner scores! And it's tied at one. That is an incredible pass. Zoyway gets the pass off the leg, and it's just hit into that top left corner. 85 kilometers an hour. We are tied at one once again. And minute 49. I had to go in this game, and it looks like Lank is going to take control of this. He's going to be hit away by his teammates from McFarland, and he's going to be going high into the air near the Alcorn goal. Lank gets it. Top. Can't get it. Nobody gets it for Alcorn. This could be dangerous. Nothing there. And there goes Vimini. Deload. Vault Destroyer trying to do something. Cannot get it. Zlankson needs a boost to be able to get something done. Boost comes up right at the exact moment he's got it. He's going to be hit off the wall. Can he get the aerial? Can't get it. And Yank has exploded. Vebby, he's got the hit. Can't get it. Saved by Zoylink. As we approach 1 minute to go, we are tied at one. Vebby gets a shot. He's going to try to put it in that center. He's got the aerial. Vault Destroyer is too high. Shot is going to be off as Yank is getting exploded. Squiddy gets exploded. Yeah, I guess what comes around comes back to bite you. Is the explosion for Squiddy. Vebby can't get a shot by Yank. Two shots. Cannot convert either to get the lead for McFarland to game number one. Vebby gets a shot up. Vault Destroyer hits it up. Way too far to the left. 30 seconds left to go. Zoylink. Shot. Yank. Too far to the left. As we approach 20 seconds left, Vault Destroyer trying to get a shot. He's got wide open net. Vebby scores! 2-1! Alcorn takes the lead. The pass from Vault Destroyer on that right-hand wall into the center, and Vebny's got a wide open net. 100 kilometers an hour. It is 2-1 with 19 seconds left to go. Shots back up. Vault Destroyer gets the first hit. Zoylink's got control. And that could have been a goal that could have tied it right there. But it looks like Vebby's going to take control. 10 seconds left. The guy gets something. One goal is all it needs. Five. Shot. Can they keep it up? And the winner is going to be Alcorn in game number one. Final score of 2-1. Vebby is your MVP for game number one. In these semifinals. Now, 367 points, one goal, two saves, and one shot for your MVP. Game number two here in the Aquadome. It's Underwater Racket League. Game number two is on. McFarland trails in this series 1-0 up into the underdog Alcorn Elks. Alex McFarland, your top seed in this tournament with a regular season record of 7-1 in matches, not individual games. They lost three individual games all year, and Squiddy's going to get a goal 11 seconds in. And that is going to be Squiddy with a pass from Vemini. It's going to be a bounce up into the center, and nobody's going to get it for Alcorn for McFarland, and that is going to be a 1-0 game right off the bat. 11 seconds in. Squiddy gets it. It's going to put it onto the right-hand side. McFarland's trying to get an aerial. Vault Destroyer's going to get the hit. Drops it down. It's going to be there for Vebby. Can he get it? Just misses. And there's it. Lank. Can he get it? It goes past all of them, but it's way too far to the right as it is going to be hit. Zoylink with the backwards hit. Does he have enough boost to get there? Nope. And Yank is going to have to retreat. Lank gets the hit. And Yank is going to come back and try to keep it in. Vault Destroyer, does he have enough boost? He does. But it's not going to be a hard hit. Zoylink is exploded. All right. The demo, first demo of the game. Lank, he's got it. That could be a goal if it's Yank gets a save. Zoylink gets it back out to center. Dangerous hit. Yep, it looks like Link is going to get that. Vemdi is just boosting along. Can't get it. Vemdi. It's there in the center. It's going to be blocked away by Link. And Zoylink's going to be able to just pass it right off to him. Hi, Zoylink. Not the greatest day. Gets it backwards. Scores! 1-1. As that passes it back, it looks like it was going to be a little too short, but it looks like McFarland's going to score right there, keeping a tie game. Return to a tie game. Yank with the first goal for McFarland, as you can hear the crowd in the background here at Game On in Final Act. And Volt Destroyer gets hit. Zoylink is going to take control. Yank into the center. Zoylink trying to get it. Cannot get it. Nobody can get it. Yank is retreating. And the Squiddy has got to take control. Link. Volt Destroyer trying to get it over top. Saved by Link. And Vemini is going to get another shot. That's going to be saved away by Link. Another shot over the top. Cannot get it. Link's going to keep it out. And it's going to go high into the air. Cannot get it. Volt Destroyer. Zoe Link hits it all the way to the other end. But it's not even close to be coming into the net. And Volt Destroyer, who we're looking at right now on the player cam, and that is going to be hit away. Zoylink is going to get that down the left hand side, takes the boost, gets the block. Can he get it? No, Volt Destroyer with the save. Pretty routine right there for Elkhorn. Volt Destroyer high into the air. Link is not going to be able to get it. Vemini gets it. It's an end. It looks like Volt Destroyer has a chance to score. Not going to happen. As he's unable to hit the ball. Yank has got control. Well, Volt Destroyer. And he gets it over McFarland. It's going to drop to the center. Volt Destroyer. 3-0. No, Yank gets the save. Counter attack coming in. Vemini can't get it. Zoylink off the post. Cannot get it. That could have been a prime opportunity for McFarland to take the lead in game number two, but they cannot convert. Zoylink high into the air. Volt Destroyer. Saiga tried to take it. He's not going to. He's only going to get a small hit. And that's still going to be dangerous if Zoylink can get it. Cannot get it. Hit it there and is going to be rolling back. Squiddy. Off to Veman. That'll be Yank on the left-hand side. Can he get the aerial? Cannot get it. He's going to have to pass it back around to Zoylink. And it's going to be taken by Volt Destroyer as the ball goes into the McFarland end. And Yank is going to hit this one back out for McFarland. Volt Destroyer trying to get a shot. It's just a little bit to the left. Destroyer can't get the hit. It's blocked away. Hey, the Squiddy. He's trying to go for it. Can't get it. Vemini. Zoylink gets another save. 1 minute to go. 1-1 between Top Seed and McFarland and Elkhorn. Alright, Yank is in control, gets it. High into the air. Gets it in. Can't get it, and Vemini's going to hit it out into the left hand side of McFarland's. And Zoylink's going to take control of that. Elkhorn gets the boost in that corner. Vemini's got a good position, but he makes a flip, cannot get it, and that can be dangerous. That could be dangerous. It is 2-on-1, but Vemini is going to be right there to get it. It is going to be taken away. McFarland, aerial, can't get it. Passed in. It's going to be another save by the Squiddy. Yeah, gets the block. Can they get it? It's just off. And Vemini gets it on the top. Scores 2-1. Volt Destroyer gets the assist, and with 11 seconds left to go, oh, Elkhorn has another 2-1 lead late in the game as they're looking to take a 2-0 lead against Top Seed at McFarland. Volt Destroyer gets it. Is going to move. Looks like Zoylink's going to get it. Link gets it. Does he have the right boost? One last chance. And they can't get it. Elkhorn is going to win this game. And they are up in the series now, 2-0. MVP for this game is Volt Destroyer, 468 points, no goals, one assist, two saves, and three shots for Elkhorn. Oh, and the only it is now a 2-0 series lead. One goal, One game away. Hey, for Elkhorn, making the state championship here for the Wisconsin Night School Esports Association Rocket League semifinals. Here we go. McFarland's in the blue, and Elkhorn is in the orange. And it looks like the Squiddy's going to get the first hit and move it into the McFarland end, into McFarland's left-hand corner. It looks like Volt Destroyer trying to get a first shot in, can't get it. Volt Destroyer goes again, cannot get it. And Zoidlink's gonna take control. Oh, Yank moving back, Vemini. Volt Destroyer, pass. Cannot get it. Volt Destroyer coming in, trying to get a shot. Scores, 1-0. And yet another fast start for Elkhorn. It's gonna be crucial if these games are gonna continue to be tight, as they're getting an early jump on McFarland. And they're looking to yield their spot in the state championship. 1-0, Elkhorn. Volt Destroyer gets hit, moves on the right-hand side. All right, Vemini trying to make it 2-0. Zoidlink gets the save. So they're going to get the hit. Can't get it. Zoidlink. High into the air. Zoidlink's going to go for an aerial. And it drops. Can you get it? No. It's going to be a save by Vemini. Another shot. Zoidlink tries to get it, but cannot get it in. Pass off to Yank. Run it to the left. Volt Destroyer's going to take it back, but Lank gets it. Can Zoidlink push it in? No, he cannot. Lank, block again. And it looks like Zoidlink's going to have to retreat. Lank. Yank also gets a shot. Cannot get it. And Vemini's moving all the way down. This could be dangerous if someone can get there for Elkhorn. Too high. And now, and the second shot is going to be too wide. Vemini gets it. It's going to put it into the center. It looks like McFarland's going to take control. Lank. Volt Destroyer cannot get the save. Can they get it around? No. Squiddy's going to take it out and keep it out of the net. Keep that 1-0 lead going for Elkhorn. Zoidlink is demoed. Oh, that's the first time that we've seen in game number 3. Zoidlink gets it. Save Volt Destroyer. All right, making a shot. Saved by Lank. Zoidlink's got the boost. And he's going to take control. Gets it over the top off of an Elkhorn defender. Saved by the Squiddy. That's going to be a save to keep it even a 1-0 game. Epic save if credited to the Squiddy. Volt Destroyer with it. And the Squiddy's going to get over top. Can he get it? Squiddy's not able to get there. Volt Destroyer's not in position. And Zoidlink is going to take control. He's bouncing it up. Volt Destroyer gets hit. It's in a great position, but it's going to be pushed back into the Elkhorn end. Save made. Zoidlink. Can they get it? No. Lank hits it out of the way. AF Squiddy, that could have been a second goal. This could be a second goal, but Lank gets the save, keeps it out. That was a dangerous position to be in if you were McFarland. And Yank is going to take the aerial. He's got the aerial, drops in, no he can get it, Vemini can't get it, but no he's there, oh, Zoidlink can't get it, Yank can't get it, McFarland just can't put it in right now, we got 2 minutes left, they gotta put one in if they want on any chance of moving on to the state finals, or at least getting an overtime. I'm Vemini, Volt Destroyer, gets it down, hits up. Yank puts it into that center. Can't get it. And Lank is going to be there, but no. Vemini is going to get it. And Zoidlink's going to have to make a save back on defense. And he can't get it again. And Volt Destroyer gets another chance, but it's wide open. And it's not going in. Lank gets it. Moves it out. Lank with the block. Zoidlink. Vemini. Over the top, can't get it. Moving back, Volt Destroyer. Zoidlink. Zoidlink cannot get it. It's going to be going in. 1 minute left to go. That's a save. Big save for McFarland. They're going to need that if they want any chance of moving into the finals. They're going to need a goal quickly. Lank. Block. Squiddy shot. Zoidlink taken away. He needs some boost. There's it. Can Lank get it in? Can't get it. And the squeeze is going to be in control. 30 seconds left to go. All running into each other. Zolake gets it up. They're in control now. Can they get it? No. Vemney's there. Light gets it on it. And Zolake almost gets it in. 20 seconds left to go. McFarland's got to get something going. They got about one or two more chances left. Vemney with the block. Leg. Zolake. Can't get 10 seconds left to go. Volt Destroyer is going to sail it forward. Outboard. This series is all but over. Volt Destroyer gets his second. Gets a goal for Elkhorn, the second for them as the Squiddy gets the assist. And that will pretty much all but seal the deal for Elkhorn for their trip to the state finals. 7 seconds to go, bearing a miracle from McFarland. Zolake trying to get control. Volt Destroyer is going to put any end to that. Can they at least get one? No. Alcard is moving on to the state finals by a final score of 3-2-0. Your MVP for Alcard was Volt Destroyer. 394 points, 2 goals, and 4 shots for Alcard, for the Elks of Alcard as they upset top seed McFarland. Moving on to the state finals. As you're live from Game On in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin for the WIHSCA State Championship for Rocket League. The other game going on for the state championship, other semifinal is between East Troy High School as they are taking on Wilmot Union. Union results for that game are pending. Ending at the moment. That game is not being streamed right now. Are you sure?
I just can't. Like, you haven't covered it, I don't know what to say.
You don't know what to say. It looks like I have lost my co-commentator.
I can't help it, I don't know what to say.
Yeah, just say what you thought about the game. Come on. Yep. Go ahead and say who you are and just our first start it out.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Ozzy hopping on right now. So that last game, what did you think about that? What did you think in terms of play style and just overall teamwork?
It seems like McFarland was playing a more of a defensive scheme. Him as they only scored 2 goals in the entire tournament.
We're going to make the local lobby. So same username password on that last one. Let's just get the lobby going. They're using the bathroom, washing the hands, getting a drink, and then we're going to load right back up for game 7, or for the finals, best of 7.
Who is that?
It's Elkhorn against East Troy.
Oh.
So if we're able to change the overlays real quick, too.
What was the series? What was the series score?
3-0 East Troy, 3-0 Elkhorn.
All right, we got a bunch of sweeps coming in.
Really interesting when you think about the way these teams play. That last game that we just saw, you can definitely see McFarland is very strategic in the way that they play. And as opposed to Alcorn, he's very...
more of a progressive.
Very aggressive in that place, for sure.
Well, it makes a lot of sense. Being the higher, being the lower seed, they got to make something aggressive. As if when you're going against a top seed like McFarland. They only lost 3 games in the regular season. He's in all of them to East Troy. All right, which is not a surprise that they're in the state championship of a 3-0 win over Wilmot Union. Union, how do you like the matchup coming up against East Troy versus Elkhorn?
Well, for sure, Elkhorn has some very aggressive play styles going for them. I think that worked in their favor overall. We'll just have to see what East Troy brings to the table.
All right. Team setting. All
right. Moving into the finals, Destroy versus Elkhorn. Really interesting to see what these teams will bring to the table. Best game out of 7. What are your thoughts so far?
Well, see.
If you just throw 1-1-1-1 after that, like the 4 ones. Cool. and then you should be able
password
to read
as well.
Right?
Password as well?
Yeah, make password. It the exact same thing. Just delete the whole thing.
just get rid of everything. If you just get rid of everything, it'll just be a library that they don't have to put in a password or they don't put in anything. Just get rid of both the name and password.
Hit.
You create match.
That is join.
Literally when they go to join local lobby.
Oh, that would be the only one.
Literally there's only one up there.
Hit.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Well, seeing East Troy play on Wednesday, they played against Omro 3 in their first round match. It seems like that it was not much I could see it from like a perspective standpoint, because it was basically domination the entire way through. The last game, East Troy won 8-1 with Omro not getting their last goal until just seconds left in the game, which was basically a pity goal, basically.
Well, we're taking a short break here at Game On Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. Let's take a break.
We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Anyway, back at twitch.tv/WIHS/_esports.
McFarland's offensive.
I feel like McFarland's had a little strategy going on, but just the execution of it was
poor execution. Shots went wide, they were being easily saved.
Another thing I'll point out to them, definitely very aggressive play stuff.
Yeah, they had a couple of wide open shots. Like, that could have been a lot worse.
Yeah.
But McFarland had a great defensive strategy in there. But looks like they're coming in.
Alright, we are back for the state finals between Elkhorn and East Troy.
We got the players loading in here. Seeing ready to see the finals, what do you think about each of the teams?
Well, we're going to have to, well, I haven't seen East Troy play an opponent like Elkhorn yet, so we're going to have to figure out how their strategy is going to be able to go against an aggressive style from Elkhorn, and already it is a 1-0 game. Hey, thoughts on that?
I think it's an interesting question. 8 seconds into the match. Definitely got to work on some stuff. For sure, East Troy's got a rough start opening, but I think they can bring it back.
All right, 1-0, Elkhorn leading East Troy, and looks like that's going to be another advantage for the Elks against the East Troy Trojans. Elgin's Vemney moving down the left-hand side. I try to get it, cannot get it, as he outs it to his own corner. Lukey Charbs. Arms, can I get Fedica trying to get a shot in? That's just going to be easily knocked away. Hey, as Vemney's going to try to get it, Lukey Charge gets it in. Going to have to go back. Wacko knocks that out. And it looks like Walter Strar.
Centered it. Misses. Wacko's coming in.
That's going to be over the top. And Wacko is going to take control. Vemney trying to make a challenge, and he successfully does. Knocks it away for it to Squiddy to be able to move down that left-hand side. All right, as Fedica is going to try. That could be a dangerous hit right there. They're setting it back in for your opponent is never something you want to do. You can get scored on like that. Vemney trying to get it. Cannot get it. Is going to go back high into that center of the area. Area 4 or East Troy. Volt Destroyer doesn't have any boost, and still doesn't have any boost.
Just trying his hardest here, just try to make it easier for his teammates to score.
Yeah, you're not going to score if you don't have a lot of boosts.
That's true.
Yes, you can make passes. Fedica makes a save. And they got control of Volt Destroyer. Blocked away by Wacko. Volt Destroyer trying to get around Lukey Charms. Nobody there. Knock,
and
knock.
Score from Squiddy.
Make it 2-0. Ultra Strider gets that assist. This is right there. 98 kilometers an hour is now 2-0 for Elkhorn.
East Troy's definitely got some major competition here, especially considering Elkhorn is very aggressive in their play style.
They're gonna have to put together a really solid defensive scheme, a little more solid than what McFarland had, or they're gonna need to play a just as aggressively to be able to score goals.
Into the match, everyone's looking really just trying to coordinate the best of their team as possible.
There goes Lukey Charbs. Demoed right there. Fedica trying to get a shot just a little bit too far to the left. And that is going to be knocked away as Vemney's looking for a spot to get a hit back to center, but nothing there. Wacko's got control. Yeah, that's a scoring opportunity for East Troy. It's going to be blocked away. Fedica setting it back in. And that's just going to roll all the way down to the East Troy end.
Waiting for the ball. Wacko coming in from behind. Old Destroyer coming in, bouncing up in the air.
Can't get it. Squiddy! Over the top and scores! Vemney gets his. It's another goal. And that's going to be now 3-0 in favor of Elkhorn.
2:30 left of the match. Very interesting play style. East Troy is definitely going to have to do something in order to combat that.
Justin's gonna have to be made aim for future matches, or even better, make adjustments right now to try to get himself back into this game. Three goals with about a little over 2 minutes is not a lot, but it is getting there. In there, they're gonna have to find some mistakes made by Elkhorn, Lukey Char.
Missing it completely.
And it looks like that's gonna be a blocked away. Wacko's got it. Lukey Charles has a lot of boost. He could use that.
Squiddy coming in from behind, right behind
him. Vemney's got it. Can't get it. Wacko, save, score. Squiddy 4-0. And this is becoming a domination by Elkhorn as they get their fourth goal, 103 kilometers an hour to that left-hand side.
Really interesting considering there's 2 minutes left in the match. Let's see how East Troy adjusts.
And now four goals is going to be, now that's very challenging. Three is probably the max you could probably come back from at this point. Point without a large amount out of basically errors made by Elkhorn. And it looks like they haven't been making any so far.
Yeah, you just hate to see it when there's great team coordination overall. Definitely some really great competitors out here today.
Fedica tried to get a shot. I cannot get it. Luki charge, trying to get the block, but it's not going to happen. Volt Destroyer. Ooh, and not there. Vemini's right there to get it. Top left corner scores 5-0.
Minute 20 left. What do you think it's looking like for East Troy? What do you think's going on right
now? They are probably a little bit frizzled on, a little bit shell shocked on their competition right now. And it's going to be interesting to see how they are going to make adjustments for game number two.
Volt Destroyer coming in.
It looks like Fedica is going to come down. Vemini, can he get the hit? Wacko, block. Squiddy, can I get it? Vemini going high into the air. He's got the, nope.
Another shot on goal. 1 minute left in this match.
Fedica is trying to get it, but he doesn't have any boost. It's not going to be helpful. And Luki misses it completely. If he made that hit,
Wacko just going in. Volt Destroyer, another goal. 6-0 first match. 50 seconds left. Do you think East Troy can make any goals to try to come back from this at all? This match?
No. This game is basically... What East Troy should probably try with their next 49 seconds is just to make adjustments, see what works. It doesn't matter how many goals you get scored on in the next 49 seconds. They're not going to win. They're not going to win this game. This game is pretty much decided. All right, make some adjustments, and hopefully in game number two you can see better results. Oh, it's if not a win. Luki Charms gets it.
30 seconds left, first match. Luki Charms going in, trying to adjust the
Whack.
Wacko coming in.
He's got the aerial. Left hand side.
Centering.
No boost. Fedekast. Saved by Vemini.
Luki
Charms
coming in for the second shot.
And Vemini's got blocked that way. 15 seconds left to go. 6-0 for the Elks against the Trojans.
10 seconds left.
And this game is all but over. Can East Troy get a goal? Salvage something from this game. It's high. They got a shot. See if they can get it. That's not going to be the case. Elkhorn wins. And 6-0. Vemni is your MVP once again. 670 points, 3 goals, 1 assist, 1 save, and 5 shots for the Elks as they defeat East Troy by a final score of 6-0. What adjustments East Troy are going to have to make to be able to be competitive in this series?
East Troy is definitely going to have to start communicating more for sure if they want to make an impact on Elkhorn. Another thing, Luki Charms and Wacko very pushing up against. Fedica is really trying to push that point that he is the support role.
All right, let's see if East Troy can make the adjustments. It is.
Volt Destroyer opening.
Is Luki Charms moving?
Luki Charms seems to be AFK right now.
That's unfortunate.
Volt Destroyer coming in, even with a man down. Wacko and Fedica.
Oh!
Wacko just obliterated. Luki Charms is back in. Volt Destroyer coming in from top right on Wacko.
And that's going to be a hit by Squiddy. Squiddy puts it in. Fedica! No! Fedica's got on the left-hand side.
Volt Destroyer trying to get it to the other side.
Cannot get it. He does not have enough boost left to do so. Use most of it to get the ball over. Wacko trying to get a block. He's got it. Vemini trying to score. Too far to the right. And Wacko.
Sending it for Squiddy. Squiddy misses it. Volt Destroyer coming in from behind.
Fedica putting it up on top. He's
definitely already see some adjustments made by East Troy trying to just stop Elkhorn just from scoring.
Well, 1-0 is a better score than 0-0. All they got to do is if they can keep that defense up, just find a mistake made by Elkhorn, and maybe they could steal a game away and use that strategy. Hopefully get a few more, but that is a risky strategy when you're trying to commit on the other team making mistakes as they just did, but they didn't capitalize on that. That could have been a goal, make it 1-0.
Wacko.
Can't get that. Wacko with the head moving down left hand side. Hit away. That could be a first goal. No, cannot get it. Wacko's got a shot. Adjustments are being made.
You can definitely see that second match starting off. Definitely both teams are trying to just improve overall. 3 minutes left in the match. Could be still anyone's game.
Most definitely. Luki Charles gets a hit. That's going up into the center. That is in favor of Elkhorn. Vemini cannot get it.
Wacko coming in from behind with a soft save.
And that is going to be pushed into the center. Fedeka moving it into the center. Can he get it? Punch it in? No. VMV with the save. Wacko. High. Will he go? Vemedy with a save.
Wacko trying again just to get the
team up. Another shot. Way too far right. Lukey Sharps is demoed. Thanks. He must have had no boost. It's because you usually don't say thanks being demoed when you have 100 boost. And it looks like Lukey Sharps is going to get an aerial. Do they got it? Vemedy gets a save, but that's not going to happen. Lukey Sharps. 1-0 East Troy. As they got their first goal of this state finals, I don't know, series, and Vemedy almost gets a save, but cannot get it in. As it is 1-0 for East Troy.
2 minutes, seconds left. You can definitely see adjustments made by East Troy.
Yeah, they're taking more shots. They seem timid in the first game, which is never a good thing. And that is just a mistake. They just...
scored by Volt Destroyer.
Yeah.
2 minutes left in the match. 5-1-1.
There should be no reason that should be that wide open.
No, not at all. Wacko did definitely try to save that. Just couldn't get to it on time.
Yeah. Even if he was on time, I don't think that was in the right position either. Fedeka gets...
no.
Nothing he could do.
Wacko coming in from the side.
Cannot get it. Vemney is destroyed. And the shot's coming in a little too far to the right. Volt Destroyer saved by Fedeka. 2 minutes left to go. East Troy, 1. Elkhorn, 1. Yeah, it looks like...
Sharp's coming in with the save on the side. Volt Destroyer just trying to get that ball back on the other side of the
knee. Cannot get it. Wacko shot. No, blocked away by his... blocked away by the Elkhorn on defense. It's
Steven. Very aggressive place down right now.
Yeah.
He
was very timid the last game. Played a lot of defense. He looks like he changed his strategy completely.
So far, it seems to be working out for them. Wacko coming in, centering the ball. Vemini coming in.
Lukey charged. Too far left. Fedeka teed off. Wacko. High. He's got a little bit of boost. So he just waiting. He knows it's not going to go in. Wacko.
Minute 15 left.
Gets it around. Oh. Uh-oh. Not about boost. Okay, now Squiddy has boost. Fedeka gets it over the top. Looks like that's going to be another hit. Luke Chubb's going to have to retreat. He's got boost to make a hit. And he missed it!
1 minute remaining. Volt Destroyer, second goal of the game. 2-1 Elkhorn.
Yeah, it looks like when Fedeka made this hit right there, Volt Destroyer's there, but Lukey Charms was not really in a position to be able to score. He might have been out.
Small moments, but you got to take those opportunities as they come by for sure.
Yeah. Elkhorn has not had as many opportunities as their last game. That could have been a kickoff goal if they were not there. Squiddy cannot get it. Uh-oh. That's going to be danger for Elkhorn, but they cannot get it. Squiddy.
It's
take it away. Scores. Elkhorn. Fitzkaka. Scores. It is now out 2-2-2. Ew, Wacko with the assist. 110 kilometers. That is a really fast goal.
42 seconds left. Fuck, still anyone's game at this point.
Most definitely. Two apiece. Volt Destroyer. That can be dangerous. Gets it away. Lukey Charms. Hi. Looks like Lukey Charms is going for it. And it looks like he's falling out of the sky.
30 seconds left in this match.
Wacko gets a save. Gonna need another one. Can't get it. Squiddy scores. And another back and forth goal as the Squiddy takes the lead. 97 kilometers an hour. Volt Destroyer with that assist. And looks like they had a chance to score, but not there.
Well, when it's this close, you really got to look at how the teams have been made adjustments. And so far, East Troy is definitely making those adjustments. Not to be familiar like the first game.
Both yeah. Ooh, that could have been a kickoff goal, and that would have for sure ended this game. Fedeka's got control. 15 seconds left to go. Cannot get it. Volt Destroyer. Wacko with it. It's high in the air. It looks like Lukey Charms has a chance. Can they keep it up? One. They got one last shot, but Volt Destroyer's going to get it out. And the winner is Elkhorn. Final score of 4-2. 3-2, yeah. Volt Destroyer is getting your MVP, 510 points, 2 goals, 1 assist, and 4 saves. It is for the Elks as they continue their path to the state championship and the championship trophies.
You can definitely see those adjustments made by East Troy. It's actually really working out for them really well. Alcorn felt that pressure a little bit more in that second match. Going into the third match now, who do you think is trying to take this?
I think at this point, if East Troy can make a few more adjustments, I think they're going to win this game.
Maybe Charms coming in from the side.
And it is very difficult to come back from 3-0. 2-0 is pretty easy to come back if you make the right adjustments. And they got it. Way too high. That should have been an easy goal.
Wacko.
But the pressure is on.
Wacko in control of the ball. Squiddy trying to just pressure him off.
Gets it. Blocked away. Squiddy. Destroyed. Man. There goes Squiddy. He's destroyed. Volt Destroyer's got to get ahead. Way too far to the right. And he's going to go back. Set it for a teammate. It looks like Engie is going to try it to Squiddy. Cannot get it. Volt Destroyer.
Lugia Charms with that save.
Not there. Volt Destroyer runs a Divinity. That's Wacko. He has already burst.
Volt Destroyer is just destroyed off to the side. 4 minutes left in this third match.
Nobody can get that. It looks like Volt Destroyer just did enough to get it over. Saved by Fetica. Or Fetkaka. Got Lugia Charms trying to go in. Fetica comes in, takes a shot, is blocked away. Vemini's destroyed.
Wacko just trying to keep the ball.
He's got a shot in, but looks like Vemini's going to keep that away. He needs boost. He's got to retreat back to his corner for it.
Lugia Charms coming in with a save. Nice. 3 minutes and 30 seconds left in this third match.
There's no goals, and Wacko's going to take control. Fetica with the on the left hand side. Gets the hit. Can I get it?
Alcorn punching up there.
Oh, that's not good hit. Wacko. You need a teammate there. Where is your teammates when you're on the attack? Heck, you're not going to score 1-on-3. Yeah, especially in this type of competition. I don't think you even get that in a regular 3v3 match.
Voltashore and Wacko just clearly see similarities in their play styles.
Yeah.
For sure. 2:45 left, the third match. 0-0. Still anyone's game at this point. Alcorn leads 2-0 series overall.
Yep, and it looks like East Troy is going to get that onto that left-hand side. Volt Destroyer puts it in, cannot get it. And Volt Destroyer is going to be able to put that into the center of the net.
Maybe trying to take control of that ball.
Can't get it.
Comes up from behind.
That guy with a block. Got control. Can he get around? No. Volt Destroyer. Oh, East Troy's got it. Vemini, can I get it? He's out of position. Wacko. He's got some boost. Decide it. Fetkaka. Oh, that was blocked away by Wacko. If he wasn't there, that could have easily been a goal. And now it's an Elkhorn counterattack. And yeah, it's over as quickly as I set. And Fetkaka with a shot. Gets in. Oh, off the post. Lukey Charms gets it. Fetkaka scores. And Elcor and East Troy takes the lead for the first time in the series. It is as they got it right in. And on the left-hand side, 1-0, East Troy.
Elcor's definitely feeling that pressure now from East Troy. 1-0, 1 minute, 50 seconds left. Third series.
Squiddy,
Wow, Volt Destroyer coming out of nowhere.
That is definitely what you call a kickoff goal.
Yep, for sure. 1-1.
And those are the types of goals that kill a team.
Yeah, definitely can discourage a team very easily. But I think so far, East Troy and Elkhorn definitely have the potential to bring this all back.
Yep. 1-1. East Troy. He got just wrecked.
Lugia Charms coming in from behind, just trying to get it away from
Volt Destroyer. Can't get it. Vemini. Oh, that's going to roll in. Vemini's destroyed. Backup's got control.
Minute 25 left.
Can he pass it off to a teammate? Oh, off the post. Ouch. Like, Wacko.
Destroyed by Volt Destroyer.
KO there. Metcalca. Loki gets it around. Wacko's there. He's going to tip it. Teammates. Metcalca. Oh, saves the destroyer. Loki charges. Wacko, they're getting a lot of shots. This is an aggressive play style.
You can definitely see East Troy making those improvements, and it's actually working out for them really well. 50 seconds left in this third match.
It's two.
Metcalca and Squiddy trying to just duke it out right there.
Yep. Yeah, looks like Wacko. Fat Cat Guy's got the boost, but it's going to be an Elkhorn counterattack.
Luki Charms coming in from the side, trying to just stop that, get her away from the center.
Fat Cat Guy hits that out. It's going to be hit into the center. It looks like Vemity is going to get it, and he's destroyed.
By Wacko.
Shot, nowhere close.
30 seconds left.
Luki Charms.
Wacko destroyed by Volt Destroyer.
A lot of destructions in this last minute play.
For sure. Wacko coming in, trying to send in that ball to get his teammates on it. 19 yes. seconds left.
It's
anyone's game at this point.
We could be going overtime. Fekaka. Uh-oh, that's a... Luki Charles gets it.
10 seconds left.
Can someone score in the 5 seconds?
Center by Luki Charles. No teammates there to help him, though. Oh, here comes...
Whoa!
A little too
can I get it?
Going into overtime here, ladies and gentlemen.
Sudden
third game
death. Luki Charms can't get it. Volt Destroyer is boom! Fat Kaka. Bet. Gets it. Keeps it out of the way. Squiddy. Wacko gets it. Keeps it out.
Volt Destroyer definitely holding back just in case his teammates need him by any chance.
Yep.
Alcorn is kind of bunching up here in this third match. I don't think it's working out for them too well.
McFarlane tried that in the semifinals, and that went very poorly.
Wacko coming in from the side. He's having any teammates to support him. Volt Destroyer blocking that shot.
He could have made a pass. If he had a teammate there, he could have made a pass and score and win this game. Vemini.
Vemini, open goal by...
Volt Destroyer gets it! Scores! 3-0! And this could be a sweep. Even as he just gets it around Wacko, almost there. And that's going to be an ups. That's going to be another win for Elkhorn. 3-0.
It's definitely those last moments that really counts when you're playing it together as a team. You definitely don't like to see it as East Troy is definitely just those continuous passes trying to just keep the pressure on.
Yep. Volt Destroyer is your MVP. 2 goals, 2 saves, and 2 shots. 598 points. Elkhorn leads the series 3-0. One more game and it will be over. Over East Troy trying to extend the series. Series. They're thinking right now, reverse sweep. They're going to need that to be able to win in the series.
Wacko gets first touch off
the button. Ooh, that's a good... looks like Volt Destroyer is going to get that. Luki Charms hits that way out into the center. I don't know, left-hand side, Luki Charms.
Luki Charms coming in from the side, surprising everyone.
Yeah. Luki Charms can't get... Wacko! Hit! Over! Locked away. Nobody's there.
In the match, you can definitely see those aggressive play styles coming back from both teams, just trying to keep them out. Definitely as Alcorn is trying to just take this.
Fekaka can't get it. Volt Destroyer. Centers it. Wacko. High into the air. Eric tries to get a pass off for a teammate, but no teammate is there.
Alcorn definitely kind of climbing up here a little bit.
Yeah.
Because they're trying to keep East Troy away from their goal. So they can win this match.
And the series. And the state championship. That's it. Backed away, Vemini.
Volt Destroyer coming in from the side.
Oh!
Witty destroyed first destruction of the fourth match.
Wacko hits that high into the air. Cannot get Vemini coming in. Fekaka just barely gets that hit. That's going to go all the way into the other end. Vemini's destroyed. Shot! Wacko, just a little too high.
Luki Charms coming in from the side, trying to center it for his teammates.
But his teammates all went back in retreat.
Wacko shot on goal.
Get another one. Can't get it. Luki Charms takes the block. Squiddy's got it on the top. It is a 2-on-1. And now everybody's coming in. Can't get it. 3:15 left to go.
That bunching up is definitely what's destroying these teams right here in these later games. For sure.
Most definitely. Volt Destroyer. Wacko. Can he get it? No.
Squiddy gets that touch off just long enough to get it. Let his teammates get up there. Yeah. He's destroyed by Fatkaka.
Ooh. Volt Destroyer, can he get that? No, he just misses. This is Wacko with a shot. Vemini with a save. Fatkaka is coming in. And Lucky Charms.
Shot on goal.
Yeah. Shot in net! Scores! Ace Troy leads 1-0!
Really interesting play style so far. You can definitely see how both teams have made certain adjustments to fit their other team's play styles for sure. Wacko coming in with that first goal.
Making it 1-0, 88 kilometers an hour. Hour, and East Troy leads 1-0 in the fourth match. Can he get over the top? Hits it in. Wacko. Fakaka. No teammate there.
Bolt Destroyer just annihilated by Fakaka. Lucky Charms coming in from the side. Wacko.
2-0. No save. Saved by Vault Destroyer, Fatkaka, but no teammates there, as they both have to retreat back for boost. Michael makes a block. Lucky Chubbs does have the boost to get there. Vemini.
Just trying to push it right in. So he misses a shot. Vault Destroyer just trying to keep it on their side.
Way
right.
Too far. All right. Vemini. Drop in. Vacko. Oh, he just missed. He just missed it. If he got that, that would have been in. Another save by Vault Destroyer. Oh, that will be his second.
Definitely see that Wacko, Fatkaka, both destroyed by Vemini, the big players of this.
There goes Lucky Charms.
Destroyed by Lucky Charms. Wacko just trying to keep it out of
his Fatkaka game. Is going to try to get a shot. That is not going to work. Vemini is going to be in control. Less than 2 minutes left to go as we're approaching the 1 minute mark. East Troy leads 1-0. Wacko's in control. That could be a goal.
Lucky Charms coming in from the side. Stopped by Volt Destroyer.
Fatkaka is taking a shot. I'm getting it in. No.
Misses that touch.
That's not going to happen. Volt Destroyer. Can they get it? Save! Hey, then that is good. That'll be a pretty big save. If East Troy wants to get back into this series. 1 minute left to go.
That play style in this game.
Oh, actually. For sure.
Wacko coming in with the touch. Stopped by Volt Destroyer.
Can't get it. Wacko with another hit. Hi. Hey, but Vemini is there for the boost as his teammates had to retreat.
Vemini coming in.
Uh-oh.
Kaka destroyed, but looks like they got the ball.
They just got it. That looked like it was wide open.
But Kaka coming in from the side.
He's got it.
No teammates are to support him, though. Lucky Charms coming in from the side.
Yeah, he
definitely gets that touch off Squiddy. Gold Destroyer.
Lucky Charms, 2-0. Wacko
coming in.
Can't get it. And it's going to be going back 20 seconds left. Volt Destroyer. Fakaka. Hits it into the corner. Cannot get it. Lucky Charms tries to get it, blocks it away. Wacko puts it in. No! Just blocked. 5 seconds left. East Troy will not get swept. Burying a aerial goal right here. And that is not going to be the case.
East Troy winner 1-3 last series. Wacko definitely MVP of the game. What do you think about the adjustments East Troy's made so far?
Not a lot of goal scoring, but they are playing much better defense.
Especially compared to that first match. Oh,
definitely. Definitely. Wacko is the MVP, 258 points, one goal on 3 shots.
You can definitely see Elkhorn feeling that pressure later on.
Oh.
For sure, they're just trying to scramble up right now. East Troy definitely giving them a run for their money.
Yeah. Elkhorn at this point is probably going to brush them off. Try to make some minor adjustments and try to close out the series here. Here, if East Troy wins this, then they're going to have to start making some major adjustments as that pressure sets.
Wacko and Volt Destroyer going at Volt Destroyer getting it to East Troy side.
Blocked away.
Wacko coming in from the side and save.
Gets it. Blocked away. Vemini. Cannot get it. Not going to happen. Looks like Vemini's going to have to go all the way around. Volt Destroyer cannot get it. Fatkaka gets it around. Lucky Charms is there. It's blocked. Save! Huge save by Vemini and Volt Destroyer. Couple of epic saves is made, and it is now 0-0. Still 0-0. Volt Destroyer gets another save.
You can see East Troy making some major adjustments compared to their first game, pushing a lot more offensively as well as trying to handle that defense.
Most definitely.
Volt Destroyer coming in with a shot.
Fatkaka. Blocked by Fatkaka. Wacko is destroyed. All right, he's back into the field of play now. He's going to be the one that's got to make a...
from the side, saves the goal.
But Elkhorn back up on top. Oh, can't get it.
Barely misses it. Wacko just trying to get it out.
Tips it over the head. That shot is not even close. Fabre gets it in. Scores 1-0.
3:45 left in this match. Really interesting play so far. Definitely, we can see where the teams have made some major adjustments, both offensively and defensively, and I think it's working out in their favor.
For sure. 1-0 right now for Elkhorn. The Elks are trying to close this one of this series out and take home a tile. Lucas Jarvis gets it. Wacko. Wacko takes control. That almost went in.
Lucas Jarvis coming in from the side, just trying to center it for his teammates to make the shot.
Fedica. Wacko's there. Yeah, the rotation's being made. They got to have two guys off on offense if they want. Can't get that. Looks like here comes Volt Destroyer, blocked away by Lukey Charms. Fedica gets it over. It around. Blocked by Fekaka. Will that roll in?
Goal. Try and just center it. Wacko might come in from the side. Never mind.
That's going all the way back to... That is going the opposite direction of what East Troy wants. Wacko makes the aerial.
Definitely seeing the pressure from both teams as...
Definitely.
Sure.
Make it 2-0.
Destroyer.
49
left in the match.
As that second goal is going to give Elkhorn some much-needed insurance.
East Troy's going to make major adjustments right now.
They got to make adjustments right now. They have no time for any experimentation. Adjustments have to be made, or this is going to be game.
Wacko coming in from the side.
Saved away by Volt Destroyer. Wacko's up on top. Volt Destroyer.
Fedkaka coming in.
Wacko.
Lukey Charms is trying to get back to that goal so he can block all those shots. But Kaka, definitely Wacko, trying to just push the ball away from there.
Most definitely. Shot made, can't get it.
It's interesting to see how these two teams definitely adapted. 2 minutes, 15 seconds left in this fifth match, actually.
Yeah, this is the fifth match. East Troy did win one.
Now 3-1, Volt Destroyer coming in with Lukey Charms.
Luke Charles trying to get one back for East Troy. Cannot get. It's around. Two on two. Never mind. Not there. He can't get there. Wacko gets the destruction. But it's going to be Elkhorn pushing forward anyway. Vebene. Wacko. Volt Destroyer. Lukey Charm.
You can definitely see East Shore just trying to get the ball back on the Elkhorn side of the arena.
Definitely. That guy trying to get that. He's got it. Gets that up into the air. Wacko with the block. Blocked away. Luke Jarvis. Well, Destroyer blocked away. That could have been 3-0. That would have been really difficult to come back from with just a minute left. Luke Jarvis. Trying to get something going for East Troy. Wacko gets a destruction.
Volt Destroyer is trying to push that ball away.
Yeah. Definitely right there.
1 minute left.
1 minute. In it. That's all Elkhorn needs to get the state championship trophy. Wacko. Going for an aerial. Pekaka. And he gets it away. Wacko trying to score right here. Gets a set. Fekaka. Can't get it.
30 seconds left.
East Troy's got to score now. Ow,
Wacko, there. Lukey Chan's definitely pushing up. Wacko trying to center it for his teammates. Can't do it, though.
Yes.
East Troy definitely just trying to keep
and we are 10 seconds left. It looks like the Elkhorn Elks are going to be your 2019 WIHSEA Rocket League State Champions as soon as the ball hits the ground.
I'm not going to touch it at this point. touch the ground there.
And there it is. And the state champion for Racket League is the Elkhorn Elks. Volt Destroyer is your MVP, 500 points, one goal, three saves, and one shot. I take it as the Elkhorn Elks are the state champions for Racket League. Bring it back over to the main menu.
Definitely in that series saw a lot of plays that could have worked out very well for East Troy, but just didn't end up happening just due to Volt Destroyer and Squiddy just trying to play that defense.
Who's your MVP for this series?
Wacko played really well. Definitely East Troy had a lot of things going for them. It just didn't end up happening. Execution, very poor first match. Moving on to the second match, made some adjustments, made it happen. Definitely trying to just reduce that 6-0 embarrassment from the
game. I agree. Elkhorn wins the series in five games. Ames, the only game East Troy won was game number 4 by a foul score 1-0.
You can definitely see how East Troy took it from a defensive side, just to create offense and just all around making it happen.
Absolutely right there. We're waiting on the awards from our it's presented by State Farm. For the trophy presentation, Asian, for our two finalists, the East Troy Trojans, your runner-up, and your 2019 state champion, Elkhorn Elks. Elks, you're live from Game On in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin, for the 2019 WIHSEA state championship. Stick around today as we got Overwatch State Finals, League of Legends Division 2 State Finals, League of Legends Division 1 State Finals, and we got Smash Finals coming up, Individual Smash. Ash, we will be back here on the WIHS Esports stream. I'm Keegan Rose, and we'll be right back. Hello everybody, I'm Kiko Rose. Welcome back to the stream, and we are here for the award show for the Rocket League State Championship in front of our State Farm banner. And we're going to take it live to Mike Dale at the State Farm Awards. Orange Pal. Here we go. Take it away. And now for the presentation for the state championship trophy. Take it away.
Hawthorne, come on down. In convincing fashion, Hawthorne, I present to you the first ever Rocket League State Championship. And then, as all champions, you're going to get a little post-game interview here. So we do have some interview questions here. So for each of you, how did you guys say that your team was affected your play style?
Well, we have somebody who was new to Rocket League, so we had to sort of play slower. And as he was a player, then we could move to the play faster. So it's not like we were kind of DC staff maybe play style this time. So
and that's it for the Rocket League portion of the award show. Up next on the stream will be the Overwatch file. We'll have presentations for trophies for that as well. After that, stick around later today for the League of Legends Division 1 and Division 2 state finals, as well as the Smash files coming up. Individual Smash files here at Game On in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. Hudson. As you can see, the view coming from inside the gaming Porsche.